In this video, we'll go over the initial setup of Tableau Bridge as well as an overview of the user interface of the Tableau Bridge client. First, at the top is the client name, which is also the name of the machine where the client is installed. In the second slot, we have the connection status, which indicates whether the client is connected to Tableau Cloud successfully or not. In the third slot, we have the site name, which is the Tableau Cloud site that the client is registered to. On the fourth slot, we have the settings menu, which also contains options to disable error reports and unlink the client from a site. You can also select the About Tableau Bridge option here to identify your Tableau Bridge version. In the fifth slot, we have data sources. By default, this area displays a list of live queries that are being load balanced or pooled by the clients across the site. This can also contain data sources that have been assigned to the specific client using Bridge legacy schedules. Please note that this list does not show data sources or virtual connections that are refreshed with online schedules. To see data sources or virtual connections refreshed with online schedules, you'll need to go to the Jobs page on your Tableau Cloud site and filter on Bridge refreshes. On the sixth slot, we have the pooling status, which shows whether the data source is part of the client pool. For a live connection, a live status indicates that the data source has a live connection and is a part of the pool of clients. Again, please note that virtual connections which utilize a live connection do not show in this list. If it is blank there, it indicates that the client is not a part of the pool. This is because the data source is using Bridge legacy schedules. The seventh slot here shows the legacy options, which will display on hover to edit or view connection information, go to the schedule, and run a manual refresh for data sources that are using Bridge legacy schedules. Please note that if you are not using legacy schedules, you can manually refresh the data source directly in Tableau Cloud through the Run Now option on your Tableau Cloud site. In the eighth slot, the client mode indicates if the client is running as a Windows application or service. We generally recommend using service mode in this situation, as that will continue to run the application after the user logs off the machine. Please know that if you are planning on running Tableau Bridge as a service, you'll want to have the user be a local Windows administrator on the machine that Tableau Bridge is installed on. Next, we will go over how to set up Tableau Bridge and link it with your Tableau Cloud site. First, you'll want to open the Tableau Bridge shortcut. This is going to prompt you to sign in with your Tableau Cloud credentials. Please note that here you will want to use an account that is a Site Administrator Creator or a Site Administrator Explorer or higher when authenticating and connecting Bridge to your Tableau Cloud site. Next, you're going to enter your site URI, which is just your site name portion of the URL in your Tableau Cloud URL. Hit continue. Then you will want to enter your password and click sign in. Then you'll want to click through your MFA. At this point, your Bridge client should be running in the bottom right corner of your screen. If it doesn't automatically appear, go ahead and click the up arrow down here and then click the plus icon to get the client to show up. Over here, you'll see the settings cogwheel icon, which lets you repair the client if any live connections are broken on the client itself. You can also unlink it from the site completely or click the About Tableau Bridge icon here to view the current Tableau Bridge version. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to change this mode from application down to service mode. And what this does will ensure that the application continues to run after the VM has been logged off of. Let's go ahead and hit OK. And then you're going to be prompted for your Windows credentials after that. Then you're going to go ahead and enter your Windows credentials here. Hit OK. And that's going to restart the Tableau Bridge client as a service on the machine. So now you'll notice the mode down here is in service mode, and when you log off the machine, it will continue to run in the background and perform extract refreshes and query live connections as well. Next, you'll want to navigate to your Tableau Cloud site. Note, if you're having issues connecting the Tableau Bridge client to the site, navigate to the settings page here and then go to the authentication tab and ensure that the connected clients option is enabled on your site. Next, what you can do is go to the Bridge tab here to adjust email notification settings to notify you when the Tableau Bridge client stops running. We will be diving into the private network allow list and custom pooling setup in a separate video, so be sure to look for that as well. If you'd like further information on setting up and configuring Tableau Bridge, as well as going over the Tableau Bridge UI, please see the documentation below the video. Thanks for watching.